Hello?
Okay, speak to Mark, please.
This is him.
Hey, Mark. My name is Matt Saylor. I'm an agent with the Colorado Bureau of Investigation. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good, sir. How about yourself?
I'm doing good, thanks. Hey, the reason I'm calling is we're doing some follow-up on the Watts case, and it's my understanding that you are a friend of theirs. Is that correct?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Would you have a couple minutes to speak to me about it?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, let me get some identifying information from you. How did you know Shanann and Chris?
Me and Chris have been best friends for almost 25, 30 years. So I've been in and out of their lives quite a bit over the years. I've met Shanann on multiple occasions. I've met their daughters multiple occasions. And me and Chris would stay in contact via phone call or text message, or if they we'd go see each other.
Okay. So were you friends with Chris before he met Shanann?
Yes, I was.
Okay. Well, yeah, I guess for 25 years you would be, huh?
Yeah.
You guys grew up together then?
We did.
Okay. So did you live in North Carolina then?
Yes.
Okay. What take you out?
I believe I'm in the Navy, so I got stationed out here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. When's the last time you talked to Chris?
I talked to him, I think it was Tuesday before that Wednesday he had confessed. And it was just through a text message.
Okay. Or the they went missing?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So what kind of family things were going on?
I knew that Shanann and his mom, Cindy, were fighting again. Because Cindy had called me and told me that they had started fighting again. And I kind of was a little upset with Chris because I texted Chris and just let him know, like, hey, man, this has got to stop. Like, you know, I'm tired of hearing this. And he reached back to me and said he understood, he knew what was going on, and he kind of clued me in on him and Shanann are going to separate and get a divorce. And that's when I told him, like, well, I'm here if you need to talk, man. And he said he would reach out to me some more, but he never really did after. She said that, and this is coming from Cindy, that Cece had a food allergy to chocolate. And I guess Cece ate a whole bowl of Hershey Kisses, and Shanann came into the living room and was just yelling at Cindy and, you know, telling her she's trying to kill her baby or something like that about because of the food allergy. And Cindy had no idea, and she claimed she had no idea about it. And they had this huge, huge argument, and she ended up kicking Shanann out of the house, telling her, you know, to leave. They were getting, but again, like, I never really saw anything that they were seeing, because I think they were more close to her than I was. You know, I was just Chris's friend, and they're the family. They're on that constant form of contact. But for me, every time I was there, I went to their house, or they would come see me, or we would text or talk. Like, they were always good. You know, they always seemed fine. And Shanann never really exhibited anything that they were claiming, but there was always, you know, after a while, there was that uneasy feeling about her. Like, something has to be there if everyone's got such a problem with her.
Okay. But you never saw anything yourself?
But I never actually saw it.
Okay. Did Chris ever tell you about any of those things that he also saw in her that her family was talking about?
He did not.
Okay.
And again, I didn't press because I didn't want to, like, you know, dig into his personal life.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. And obviously you liked Chris because you were friends with him for 25 years, but what can you tell me about him?
Chris, he has always been a quiet guy. He only opens up to the people that he's comfortable with. He's the type of guy that would do anything for you. He'd bend over backwards for you, and he's been there for me multiple times when I went through issues with relationships or whatever. Like Chris is, he's been a brother to me, big time, and I still love him as a brother. Like, this all comes as a shock, but still, like, Chris is a good guy, and the way the media is painting him out to be this, that's not Chris at all.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. And he loved his daughters very, very much.